viewers to a panel discussion on BFSI on our Tech Next show. The banking, finance and insurance sector is being disrupted by a surge of new players in the market. The global pandemic has also given a boost to the digitization of BFSI domain. To discuss this on our panel, we are talking about the scope, advantages, future and challenges in BFSI domain. To discuss this, we have three eminent guests with us from the BFSI sector. My panelists today are Rahul Jain, who's the co-founder of All Cloud Enterprise. Then C. Chalappan, who's a functional consultant in the BFSI domain. And Pawan Adipuram, who's the founder of founder and CEO of Chitmonk. Welcome, gentlemen. Welcome to the show. Let's start with Pawan. Pawan, what is Chitmonk into?
Thank you, Sunil. Thanks for having me here. So Chitmonk is more like, you can think of it as a Chitfunds 2.0 design, right? I mean, I think Chitfunds have been playing an important role in the financial services for almost like at least a century, right? I mean, not even decades, at least it has been from the King's era. So we have, and it has been, you know, playing an important role at financial services and has a Chitfund Act, which is actually governing the entire Chitfund business across the country, right? There is an act which protects the interest of the subscribers across the country. But this act is very old in terms of the way of execution and the operations as well. So Chitmonk is a very bold step to reimagine that, you know, the way of working of Chitfunds. That is what I would say. Instead of playing the role of a traditional Chitfund company, we are trying to reimagine the Chitfund processes, how they can actually reimagine their processes and attract new segment of customers, right? I mean, if you see today, most of the Chitfund customers are the average age group of a Chitfund customer today is more than 30, which means to say the cream segment of working class is completely left out of Chitfund business. How can we make this more attractive to that segment is the philosophy which was driving us to think different in terms of bringing a Chitfunds 2.0 kind of an environment. Having said all of that, we are a pure tech play company. We are only tech enablers of the Chitfund companies. We are not running Chitfund companies. That's one thing which is very, very clear. We are more of a tech players enabling the Chitfund ecosystems end to end. That said, again, we also work with the government as well in terms of bringing the administration. So it's not just solving the problem of the Chitfund company and the subscribers, but we also work with the government to administer the entire Chitfund activities of the state, especially in Telangana. And for that, of course, we use emerging technologies like blockchain to bring all that activity onto the platform. So that's in short what we are doing.
Great. So Chitfund Telangana is big time player in Chitfunds, isn't it? Rahul, your company All Cloud Enterprise is basically into providing technology for BFSI, and the players like Chitmonk are the ones probably whom you would be working with, and these are the players who are disrupting the BFSI space. The traditional banking and finance is completely disrupted by players like Chitmonk, isn't it?
A lot of innovation is happening, and what All Cloud does is essentially provide a platform that can help banks, financial institutions innovate on the core technology that we have, integrate it with multiple systems, and then create an ecosystem out of it. So definitely, providing this lending technology and the API technology that we have enables banks, financial institutions to onboard customers better, lend better, and manage their loan book. We heard how Chitfunds are important instruments of savings. Loans are an equally important part of the financial ecosystem because loans promote growth, loans promote the economy, and then create a lot of employment. And what we've seen is that less than 4% of SMEs actually are able to have the credit in the fashion that they want. So our platform essentially enables banks to give better customer experience and digitize their flows and processes. And so that's what we do. And yes, there is a lot of activity in fintech, and we're in the right space now.
Chalappan, you know, people like Rahul and Pawan are completely disrupting the old, you know, the traditional banking and finance sector. You are somebody who, you know, who observes this space very closely. What are your thoughts? What are you seeing, you know, especially given the last 18 months of pandemic?
Actually, based on the Rahul words, as he mentioned, now the market is growing and it is emerging in a better space. At the same time, we are elevating from our normal paper-based process into system-oriented. And now we are, most of the people are pitching into the artificial intelligence and cryptocurrency basis. So business-wise also, we are growing into the next level, as well as technological-wise also, we are elevating from the current status to the next status. So it's a right time to pitch in into this market. At the same time, if we ask, it's a time to market for this business. Yes, we are good. And then right now, lending is in peak, both in agricultural side as well as in the commercial or consumer durables kind of a business. At the same time, MSME vendors are growing now because due to this pandemic situation, most of the people might get struck due to the business, all those things. Now it is evolving in the MSME sectors.
Great. Pawan, you know, your space is where, you know, the chit funds, typically if you go by Telangana and Hyderabad in particular, you know, it is the street vendors, you know, most of the maids, you know, you talk to them, they're into chit funds. You know, it is seen a segment where you see the low middle class, this segment is, you know, highly, you know, involved into it. And also the large chunk of, you know, illiterate population is also there. How are you, you know, how's your technology helping connect all these people together? Because it's about using the technology as well, isn't it?
See, I think you touched upon two different segments of customers here, Sunil, right? One is the bottom of the pyramid customers who are probably more of a microfinance kind of customers, not chit funds, I would say. But then there is a middle segment as well who are actually, you know, between the banks and the microfinance, right? I mean, there are always segment of customers who are above microfinance and below the banks and financial services because of the nature of business they are doing, or because they are kind of outside the formal, institutions like formal financial services. So these are the segment of customers who are typically, more active in the chit fund business. Now, I think all of us understand that, you know, there's a lot of unregistered activity in the space as well, the chit fund space. So it is huge in terms of, if the organized sector is X, the unorganized sector of chit fund business is at least 100 times the X, okay, which is very, very different. We are definitely not targeting 100X kind of customers, I would say. But definitely the thought process is, why are these customers not getting into the formal chit fund business? See, every subscriber who are actually doing a chit fund business in the registered chit fund companies, they are almost close to the financial services, formal financial services, so to speak, of non-banking financial services companies and all, right? So why is this 100X customers not coming into the formal segment is the thought process again when we started. Now, the entire journey of Chipmunks or the product journey or the vision for us is always to enable the tech companies to think and attract these customers, right? I mean, there is always enough pie for them to capture. The biggest thing in chip fund business is, right, if you think of a registered chip fund company or any business, chip fund business, right, the biggest thing is the underwriting. I mean, the fear of underwriting an unknown subscriber is very, very high. So you will see that, you know, most of these chit fund companies play very small in terms of, you know, knowing known segment of customer base or known customers only, right? So they would not cross that hurdle of, you know, reaching an unknown customer and all. That is where we are bringing technology to their help and say, hey, don't worry, we are here to onboard your unknown customers, do a financial analysis of that customer, help you understand how to underwrite those customers better, right? I mean, that is possible using technology today. And that is where our entire focus in terms of building the technology comes in. And again, all of this technology is to push the chit fund companies, go and acquire more customers. That's the essential model we are working on, Sunil, currently. And I think it is definitely, I would call it as more of a, like I said, a daring step, right? I mean, changing the way the chip fund companies operate, changing the way the chip subscribers think about chip fund business is a very, very, very tough thing. But yeah, we are at least making some important steps in that direction.
Correct. Well, no, I agree with you. My own maid, is into chit fund, and I know every month she puts in about 2,000 rupees. So, you know, that's a small amount of money, you know, it starts with, and today pretty much everyone is, is into it. So, Rahul, technology definitely is playing a big role in rolling out or making financial services accessible to a common man, right? Today you can be walking through a sabji mandi and you would definitely find somebody scanning a QR code, whether Paytm or Google or PhonePay. And also somewhere I think there, the established institutions like the private sector banks and public sector banks, they kind of lost out also, isn't it, into understanding this trend or in a way underestimating the Indian consumer. Won't you say that?
I think, initially, yes, banks did lose out on the bet of fintechs. But what we are seeing now is banks also becoming fintechs. For us, any company, any bank or any institution that is using technology to lend or to acquire customers or underwrite them is a fintech. And we are the techfin for them. So when we speak for customers or, traditional finance companies, traditional banks, all the thought processes today are into digitization. And moving up to digital, it's also transformation. And the next thing that I expect to happen is APIfication of the ecosystem, where all these systems will be integrated so tightly that multiple data points will be collected by each entity. And then when you say that, you walk into a sabji mandi and there is somebody scanning a QR code, everybody's getting one large ecosystem. And we will see that the kind of products the banks and financial institutions will come out with in the near future are going to be addressing the needs of so many consumers in different sectors with a different and specific product range. So yeah, banks are catching up to the fintech space, and definitely, they have to be relevant today to the consumer as well. You see, everything is happening on mobile and they can't be averse to it. So they have taken steps towards it, and I'm sure there will be more innovation from banks on this one. And they're tying up with fintech. So every day you hear that a bank is tying up with fintech to specifically lend to a certain company, to specifically onboard certain customers, or to provide insurance, or to provide mutual fund services. So this is the trend that's going to be taking on a huge wave now.
If they don't, I think if they don't do it, then they'll be left behind. Talapan, where do you see this going? I mean, do you think there is more space available for more of Google Pays and Phone Pays to come into this into the segment?
Mostly, if you ask me, yes, we are looking into a Paytm or PayU kind of digital transactions. Even customers also willing to do in such a transactions to avoid to walk into the branch or some other things, because it might happen within a seconds. At the same day, I will get account credit also. So I don't need to, there will be no delay to get a confirmation from the bank or any other guys. So it's like a first in, first out. If we paid now, immediately within a minute or 2 minutes, I will get the respective income in my bank account.
Pawan, the way technology, has made space or got into financials, where do you see technology taking us? Especially when it comes to BFI space.
Sunil, I think these are definitely very exciting times, right? I mean, like you said in the beginning, one of the questions which you asked Rahul about the banks getting behind. For me, I always felt, they are smart. I would say banks are very smart because they are focusing on what they are good at, right? I mean, they are managing huge loads of money, and all of the financial services company, fintech companies eventually want to become banks. So we cannot always say that, banks are really falling back. I wouldn't call it that way. But having said that, technology is definitely playing a big role. think of all the new banks coming out saying that, you know, I'll acquire customers for you. What are they essentially doing? They're in the end of the day acquiring customers for banks. It doesn't matter, right? They're just producing another layer of service on top of the banking part is what I see. And the recent part of, you know, e-rupee coming out is a very good way of looking at, you know, how technology can be used at multiple levels. But of course, it comes with lots of other challenges as well. So it might kill the other part of it, right? I mean, e-rupee probably might kill the Jandan accounts, which are open for only operating, sending the monies to the all, you know, direct benefit transfers, right? All the DBTs which are happening. Now the government wants to do it through e-rupee, which is a very good way of doing it, because a lot of money is getting diverted, or there's a lot of hops in between the money reaching to the end customer. And now using technologies like e-rupee, again, things are changing, right? So I say it's very interesting times. Again, having said that, of course, government or India is also looking at CBDCs coming into play, which is again a very interesting topic to discuss about. And I'm definitely looking forward. I mean, all these things, I mean, e-rupees, CBDCs, the new banking services, technologies, all of them are related to technologies, right? I mean, more than money management, because at the end of the day, the financial services management is nothing, right? I mean, saving, borrowing, or lending and investment. So if all round, it's probably small pockets, if you talk about small briefcases, or everything is about revolving about money management. But technology, what we are talking now is more in terms of, you know, delivering these financial services effectively. And I think the technology will continue to play a big role, and we'll have a very big, you know, we'll see a lot more changes probably in the next 5 to 10 years is what I think.
Okay. Chalappan, you know, we see these days pretty much, you know, the big brand names, at least in India, the likes of Airtel, they also have some kind of, you know, financials, like a wallet in it. Do you think going forward, many companies would actually start having, you know, a dedicated, or at least change their, you know, their business toward being more financially driven business, like the Airtel I was talking about?
We can try it out there, but it's like a trial and error, because whether Airtel succeed in that particular wallet kind of a business means still they are trying to achieve their maximum target, but people are not yet that much used with the Airtel kind of a people. But if you are asking a Google Pay or a Paytm kind of a stuff, even if you are, you can able to see in the roadshop guy also utilizing the same thing with business account as well as with the normal accounts. So where we are pitching, how we are promoting, it's more important related to that. The branding, how they did and how Airtel did, there was a difference. But futuristic purpose, yes, it will happen.
Rahul, how do you see the future of BFSI?
The future of BFSI is quite strong. It's one of the oldest industry, and it will be thriving. What change we will see in BFSI is that there will be a lot of inclusiveness, because there will be multiple channels on multiple places where people will be able to access services. As you just said that, you know, big techs, maybe it's Amazon or Apple, or for that matter, Google, all of them have opened channels for customers to access, and it's an integrated network. So today you can send reminders on WhatsApp and a payment can be initiated, right? So it will all be very bundled into one, as one ecosystem, where there will be a lot of interaction between technologies, interaction between platforms. And I think BFSI is going to be a major player in this, you know, the whole lifestyle of a user. Right? There is going to be buy now, pay later. There are going to be solutions or products given to them at a point of sale. And these things will definitely improve the whole lifestyle, the whole living condition of people. And everybody will be able to access credit. Everybody will be able to save in a small amount. And we've seen already the start of that. And it's going to be growing from here.
So, Pawan, final word for you from you. You're also using blockchain technology. Do you see in coming time blockchain will play a bigger role, a growing role in the BFSI segment?
Absolutely. I mean, I think I'm very confident. The way India is looking at blockchain, the way the crypto markets are evolving in India, I think it's not too far. We will definitely see a lot of change in the way we operate cryptocurrencies, or the way we you know, use blockchain technology for different, you know, financial services. I think it's a lot of use cases are there. I mean, definitely, yeah, I mean, I'm very, you know, very strong proponent of blockchain, definitely. And I strongly believe that our use case of chip funds also is a very, very good use case in terms of pushing the blockchain technology to the next level. So, of course, yes, I mean, blockchain is the future. Blockchain will impact a lot of BFSI services across the world, across the country as well.
Well, with that, we come to the end, gentlemen, as we're running out of time. Thank you very much for joining us, and we hope to see you again on some of our other shows.